Hello and a warm welcome to the Polykit channel. Over the last month, I built an analog voice card for synthesizer. I've been so pleased with the result that I decided to build a semi-modular, patchable, monophonic synthesizer out of it. The idea was to bring out all parameters of the voice card and make them patchable or at least controllable. In addition, there are a few utility circuits like a mixer, a multiple and a wave folder. The size of the interface should be the same as the voice cards and stacked on top of. For the case, I created a simple 3D printable model. Like all my other projects, it is publicly available on GitHub, so everybody can build one on its own. I designed all printed circuit boards and also the front panel in KiCad. I got quite used to the process while building my polyphonic synthesizer a while back, but it was the first time I used surface mount components for my build. Space is limited on the board and more components are only available in a SMD package. For soldering, I used a rework station which uses hot air to melt the solder paste. I struggled a bit at first, like components got blown away, but with some practice I managed to finish the build. If you enjoy content like this, please consider subscribing to my channel. This really motivates me on doing more videos like this. The specs are the same as the voice cards, everything is fully analog. Here are its key features. A VCO with saw, pulse and triangle signal. An envelope generator, a multimode filter with 8 different filter responses, an external input and a panning stereo output. If you are interested in more details, please take a look at the voice card video series for a complete feature list. In addition, there is a LFO where the waveform can be blended between triangle and pulse signal, a wave folder, a 2-channel mixer where one output can be attenuated, an additional attenuator, a buffered multiple, different offset voltages and the power supply. Some connections have presets when there is no patch cable in the socket. This is outlined by the labels in the brackets on the front panel. Input and output parameters are clearly marked. All control voltages range from 0 to 5 volts. So starting from the top, there is a 1 volt per octave input to change the oscillator's pitch. That means a keyboard or sequencer which provides that voltage is needed. There are inputs for gate, trigger and frequency modulation. An external input is mixed together with the pulse signal of the oscillator, where the pulse width can be turned to 0%. The external input defaults to the output of the waveform. PWM is voltage controllable. There are inputs for hard and soft synchronization of the oscillator. Left-right panning of the output is voltage controllable. The VCA can be controlled externally and defaults to the envelope generator. Filter resonance and frequency can be voltage controlled as well. The attenuator input defaults to +5V offset voltage. The first input of the mixer is wired to -5V by default. These voltages can be used, for example, as an offset for the input signal of the waveform. There's a multiple which brings out two buffered outputs of the input signal. There are outputs for the envelope generator and the LFO. And last but not least, the wave folder where the input defaults to the mixer's output. As you can see, there are quite many variations by patching all these parameters. In addition, it is possible to connect it to external gear and make it even more versatile. There are ports for the main parameters like envelope generator, LFO and filter controls. The switches controlling the waveform of the oscillator, external input, modulation of filter parameters and filter mode. I'm quite happy with the outcome of the monophonic synthesizer, although it was only a byproduct of the voice card. It offers a lot of variety by combining different parameters and adding external gear to it. The multimode filter is quite unique for a synthesizer like this. If you're interested and into serious soldering, you can find all schematics and layout files on my GitHub account. There will be an upcoming video with more details and patching ideas. Alright, thanks for watching, see you next time and bye for now.